What's going on, filmmakers? I'm Alexandru Don, and since the Christmas is very close by, I want to take you behind the scenes on a Christmas commercial that I've shot recently.
Splendor. Magia sărbătorilor începe cu tine. Dăruiește amintiri prețioase și împarte bucuria cu cei dragi. Splendor. Strălucește în fiecare zi.
So, let me know what you think about this commercial. Even though it's in my native language, I hope you can appreciate the images and how it looks, because this is what we're going to talk about. We're going to go behind the scenes and I'm going to show you my process of getting this images with the Sony FX6.
All right, so starting off with the lighting, I went for a pretty simple lighting setup and I chose to use a big softbox with the Nanlight Forza 300B. And that's mainly because I wanted to have a little bit of a warmer tone. And Forza 300B has the possibility to change its color white balance, so that's why I went for it. And the other lights that I used were Forza 60B with a projector lens and a few PAVA tubes. And that's pretty much it. I went for a pretty simple lighting setup. Now, talking about the camera, I went for the Sony FX6 with the 50mm f1.2, which is an amazing lens. And I mostly used autofocus. And I know this is crazy and it's something pretty new for me, but autofocus is damn amazing on this camera. And as you can see, the footage looks absolutely stunning and the f1.2 is amazing. I shot almost everything at f1.2, which is kind of crazy, but I love how it looks. It has something special to the image. So the whole story of the commercial is happening at night, and the studio that we filmed in didn't have blinds, so we kind of had to block all the light coming from outside. So we used some black material. And here is Chipri, the guy behind all my behind the scenes and the guy that helps me as my first AC all the time. Before we started shooting, there was a photo shooting going on that is for the same campaign, and we kind of had to wait for the photo shoot to end in order to start doing our job as well. And soon after they finished, we started shooting, and we went chronologically in terms of shooting because it's simple and it was pretty easy. The script is pretty simple. And the reason why everyone is staying and looking at my camera in these shots, it's because my Dwarf Connection wireless system did not work, and I don't know why, but soon after a couple of minutes it started working. I'm guessing it was some interference or something like that. But as you can see, even the close-up shots with the watch and everything, I filmed them in autofocus, even though it was quite hard because I wish Sony FX6 had focus tracking. I really hope they're gonna do something about it, but in the meantime, it worked fine. The studio was built inside of a studio, so we had fake walls to make a bedroom and we had fake walls to make the next room that we see in the commercial. And as you look at the footage, you can tell that it looks really good, and that's mostly because we chose to have a really simple lighting setup that it's easy to control. And next up, we filmed a couple of special effects, which were really simple after all, but I make sure to put markers on the floor, make sure that everything stays input so the effect works. And usually when you want to do effects like this, you kind of have to put your camera on a tripod and add a little bit of handheld movement in the post-production and everything will look pretty good. I had to make sure that we made this effect work because I didn't want to get back home and have a ruined effect, so I popped up my laptop and I started editing right away in order to make sure that the effect works, and it did, so that was pretty cool. It's really helpful to take your time and try and do things on set right for the first time and don't have to correct in post-production, because usually when you do them right from the first time, it's better than in post-production, my experience. So moving on to some beauty shots, which I really love how they turn out. Again, this is a very simple lighting setup. The softbox and a top light that it's a different color. It's a PAVA tube. And as you can see, that is all. Now moving on to the next shots where she opens the box and we have the Christmas tree in the background and all that. Here we have a little bit more light, but not really that much. So I have a backlight on her. I have light in the back of the Christmas tree because I wanted to give a little bit of separation between her and between the Christmas tree and the wall. And that's why I have that backlight there. But overall, really simple setup in terms of lighting because it's not always the lighting the most important. It's also the set that you film on or the location, because these two things work together. When you have a really good set, it's very easy to light. It's very easy to make things work. Lighting wise, it was really simple, and that's mainly because of the location. So moving on to the next shots where she puts the box in the Christmas bag, it was really simple as well. Everything I shot was handheld. It went really smooth and really fast. We shot the whole thing in like 2 hours. And that's crazy. This is like what you want to achieve when you go shooting. You want to be as fast as possible because at some point your actresses and people on set will get tired, and you kind of want to do things fast. So working with autofocus made things so easy. Check out these shots. They look absolutely amazing. Autofocus worked great. And with all this being said, I hope you enjoyed this commercial. Leave me down some comments about what you think about this breakdown. And if you liked it, please subscribe. And in the meantime, enjoy and have some fun. Cheers.